Okay then.
Hey, excellent.
Mum says I have to be the woman of the house now.
Want some?
Thanks.
You said what?
Getting all over the table.
Effie, what?
Mum says I have to be the woman of the house now and take care of you and Dad.
Mum says? She can't talk to you, so what are you saying?
Thea, Helen and all the women, they say Mum's still in the house, right?
Mm-hmm.
40 days after the...
After she died, right?
Her clothes stay in the wardrobe for 40 days because she's still here.
That's a sort of custom, you know? It's like a way of remembering these things.
And if she's still here, I can speak to her.
But she can't talk back to you.
Why not?
Dad, can you explain this 40-day thing to Effie, please?
Mum's still in the house, right, so I can talk to her.
Sure.
Sure? Sure, what's that supposed to mean?
You're right, Effie. Your mother's alive and always will be. Here in our hearts and there in heaven. Alive and looking out for you.
This is nuts.
Hey, come on, Nick. Hey, don't throw away tradition. Tradition's what makes us who we are. Okay.
She says Nick's upset. She understands.
Mm. You talk to your mother as much as you want, hey, honey?
I'm living with crazy people. Con, you've got to tell your mum to lay off a bit, mate. All that stuff about mum being in the house for 40 days is driving me nuts.
What's your problem with that?
It's crazy. Effie is talking to our dead mother.
What's crazy about that?
She's dead.
Everyone knows dead people can talk to you, Nick.
Chucka, don't start on that stuff, OK? Just don't start.
Look, my grandmother used to visit me in dreams, all right? There's nothing crazy about that.
Yeah, maybe Chucka's right.
Oh, yeah, anything Chucka says is right.
Lay off me.
Hey, at least she's got an open mind, eh?
Oh, Steve! Can't touch it with your hands, Steve.
Get into it, Steve.
Watch out!
Oh, yeah! Not bad for a rugby player, Steve.
Hey, Steve, over here.
Sir?
You missed the test.
Yes, sir.
Hey, well, the supplement is on Thursday afternoon after school.
Well, Thursday, I can't. It's impossible.
Your assessment depends on it.
Oh, I've got rugby training on Thursday.
Tough.
Sir, do you realise that if I don't make training, I don't make the team?
Listen, mate, everyone who missed the test has to sit the supplementary, and that includes you.
Fine.
Just don't do this to my soccer team, okay? Their morale's low enough.
Check it out. This'll be good.
Mm. Oh, great. You got a minute?
The answer's no, Bill.
You don't know what I'm gonna ask.
Yes, I do.
Look, I know Steve can be a bit of a pain in the ass, but he's my key player.
Bill, I've already told him.
Come on, be reasonable. Can't you put the test on till a bit later?
Look, if I back off, that's a signal that every decision I make is open to negotiation.
Oh, come on.
Why is he a good rugby player?
Well, he's got football brains, ball skills.
And he gives the opposition a second chance, does he? Listen, if I show any sign of weakness with Steve, he'll just walk right over me and the others will follow. He does the test when I say he does.
So, Hamlet's talked to the actors and he's organised with them to do what?
To reenact the murder of his father.
Right, to reenact the murder of his father. Now, why?
To get a confession, like Columbo.
Yeah, to get a confession, perhaps. But what if he can't get a confession?
See if Claudius looks guilty so as he can kill him.
Right, so he has to be sure that it was his father's ghost who spoke to him, right?
The guy's a nutcase.
Hamlet?
He's a nutcase.
Hamlet was one very sexy guy. Hey, he's like you, Nick.
He's a fruitcake.
See what I mean?
He's got these fantastic eyes.
Danielle, are we talking about Hamlet or Mel Gibson here? No, because the actor isn't quite the same as the character in the play.
Oh, he's heaps better in Lethal Weapon anyway, miss.
Yeah, what about Mad Max?
All right, in drama we can discuss Mel Gibson. In English we discuss Hamlet.
This stupid nutcase, you know, they should have had him on medication, miss. Like this thing over here. He's out of it.
Who's on medication, Nick?
All right, Nick, it's an interesting point of view. Do you want to try and justify it from the text?
What, he sees ghosts, he talks to ghosts, he's a loony tune.
Well, if you look at when the play was written, you know, most people believed in ghosts.
People still do, miss. Heaps of people see ghosts. Hamlet just didn't know if it was a ghost or an ordinary...
Chuck, I told you not to start on that stuff.
Nick? Nick?
What's the problem? Nick?
All that stuff about ghosts. If he's talking to Mum and Dad says it's okay.
Well, maybe it's just something
Don't
you need
Don't you start, miss. Maybe it's okay to talk to dead people. It's not okay when they start to talk back.
Look, Effie's just a little kid.
Effie says Mum's in the house for 40 days and she's talking to her.
Well, when you've known somebody really well and they're not there anymore, you know, you say, so-and-so might have said such-and-such.
Yeah, but we don't say so-and-so is saying such-and-such. Mum is dead. Dad's lost the plot and the house is in a mess and Effie's talking all this crazy stuff. So I need Hamlet like I need a hole in the head.
Look at these guys, man. What a bunch of wankers.
The coach has taken the state under 17s, mate.
We beat them, we show the rest of the school what we're made of.
The strike is cute.
Right.
Not as cute as you, Stevie.
Hey, losers!
Oh, God, I can smell his breath from here.
Checking out who's gonna beat you next, are ya?
We're looking for a boyfriend for you, Rivers!
Ah, your mother!
To you too, mate. One day, man, I'll put him down, I swear. One day.
Yeah, sure.
Look, Christina, different people have different ways of grieving, okay?
Yes, I know. Right. It's not that.
Well, listen, you know, the Greeks have got their 40-day thing, okay? That's something they've got to go through.
Yeah, but George isn't coping. The house is a mess.
Well, it's going to take time.
Look, Effie's doing all the cooking and she's only 10. Nick's got this crazy thing about ghosts.
So it won't be like that forever.
What about a housekeeper? No, just until they get over things.
Sure, it's not a bad idea.
That might just help the kids out for a bit, but I'm not so sure about George.
Well, what about soccer? Why don't you get him coaching the soccer team again?
No, not soccer.
No, come on, it'll help get his mind off things. It'll be good.
I can't, okay? I can't.
Look, I just thought it might make you feel better, you know? Take your mind off things.
No. I don't want to get my mind off things. Got it?
Take it easy, Dad.
Yeah. Okay. Look, I'm sorry.
No. No, look, it's okay. I understand.
No, you don't understand. I'm finished with coaching. It's over, okay? Finished. Hey, that's lovely. That's just like Mum used to make. It's terrific. Anyway, I don't have the time.
Well, look, if you've got a problem with time, why don't you get a housekeeper? No, just for a few hours a day.
A woman in the house? No, we already got a woman. Hey. Hey.
I'm getting out of here. You know, Milano was over my house before, trying to snap Dad out of it.
Yeah?
No go.
Don't worry, mate. Maybe when he sees our new uniforms, he'll wake up.
Uniforms? You ripped or what?
You see that guy over there?
Sign. That scumbag. What about him?
He makes soccer shirts, right? In his own sweatshop.
Yeah, and the girls that work there get treated like dogs. What's new?
Him and me, mate, we're going to play some pool.
Against him?
Money against 15 shirts.
Mate, he's gonna wipe the floor with you.
Don't worry, man, I can take him.
You won't even get a chance to chalk your cue.
Yeah? You watch.
Simon?
Yeah?
What?
Yeah, I'll be right over.
People need to do those bitches out of fight in my shop.
Hey, told you before, I'm the only one allowed to say bitch in here.
You watch, mate. Tomorrow, I'll make history.
Ισπανακόπιτα είναι πολύ δύσκολη. Δεν μπορώ. Too hard. Ίσως στη φάδα. Στη φάδα, anybody could cook a stew, yeah. Hey, that might be Auntie Helen.
She can't cook for us forever, Dad.
Mr. Poulos.
Hmm?
Mr. George Poulos.
Yes.
Huh? I'm Mrs. Ziano. Stella.
Helen was going to phone you about me. Mm-hmm. I brought over Helen's pasticcio.
Oh, come on in, please. I mean, we were just starting to cook something.
Oh, nice kitchen, very nice. Mm-mm, with our stove, here we go. Helen says it needs its final half hour.
Sure.
It's final cooking.
$3.50.
Really? Very good.
I'm Effie.
I'm Stella. How do you do? And Helen didn't phone you.
No. What about?
Me. I'm so embarrassed.
No, don't be embarrassed.
I am. Oh, look, it was like this. A teacher at your son's school, right? Christina something.
Christina Milano.
Milano, Christina Milano. Thought you needed a housekeeper a couple of hours a day. And Helen thought of me and was going to phone you. I'd better go.
No. Hey, sit down. Come on. Effie makes a great coffee. Or a glass of wine?
Yes.
Good.
Could I have both?
Sure.
I've been running all day. Thank you. Cheers.
So you're a friend of Helen's?
Oh, not exactly. She sometimes comes into the shop I work at.
Well, can I be frank with you? You don't look like a housekeeper. You look more like a doctor's wife.
Me, a doctor's wife?
And I'm not sure I can afford someone who looks like a doctor's wife.
Well, I dressed up a little to impress you. I mean, I could dress down. I could wear a headscarf. Would that help?
That would help, but...
Mr. Boss, I'm not a doctor's wife. I'm a woman on her own. I have a daughter, part-time job in a shop. But to be frank, I need the work. Helen said 2 hours a day, Monday to Friday, $15 a day. What do you say?
Helen said I can afford that?
She said not to take less.
I think we should try. You wouldn't have to wear a headscarf unless you wanted to.
Thank you.
My son Nick, Mrs. Ioano.
Hi, Nick.
Hello.
And you know Con, Helen's son.
Oh, Con. Hi there. Right, yeah.
Mrs. Ioano is maybe going to help us out a bit with the housekeeping.
She's old enough to be your mother, mate.
Hey, man, that's exactly what's his name again? Oedipus. Who said that?
Actually, it was your mum that suggested her.
Mate, I reckon you guys should hire her.
All right, can we talk about the team?
Team?
Con?
What team?
Con, if we lose another game, mate, we're history.
Look, mate, once I get those shirts off sign, I'll be cheering.
In your dreams, Con. New shirts aren't going to do it for us, man. We need a new coach. Okay, we need another striker, you know that. And on top of everything, we need a win.
You want it all in that order?
Get serious, man.
Look, mate, we'll spy on them, right? Find out their every move, and then we'll rip them.
Dead. I don't know, mate. I think this team is stuffed. I really don't think we've got a chance at all.
Listen to you. You say that? You believe it? Anyone can be beaten. Just get it together. Anything is possible. And come on, dinner's on the table. Pasticcio, you staying, Con?
No, I better go.
You can say that to me. You can't even get yourself moving. You're gonna say that to me? Danny. Yeah, miss over here.
Oh, miss.
Yeah, all right.
Hi. Pretty good reflexes you got there.
How are yours this morning?
Here we go.
Hey, Graham.
Hey, Bill.
Boss wants to see us both.
I'll take that, thank you.
Oh, good one, man. That was real smart. Well done, Con.
You mean it.
Oh, yeah.
Gentlemen, I respect both your positions, but I would like to see a resolution that would benefit the school.
Me going soft on discipline is not going to benefit the school.
No one in their right mind would say you were soft on discipline, Bill, which is exactly why you should support me. You can't administer this test at another time? Not now, I've drawn the line. Of course, if Bill had give ground, Steve could still play.
Misses the whole point. The rule is no train, no game. I can't bend that, not even for Steve.
You two aren't exactly making this easy, are you? Steve needs discipline, and other students need to see that we don't play favourites.
Hey, now you're arguing my case for me, mate. Team discipline's probably the main thing those kids get from this school. It's something most of them don't get at home. Something that they're going to need when they hit the outside world.
Now you're making my case for me, mate!
But a win would lift school morale. He's my 5'8". He's my goal kicker. I need him.
You need him? I thought you said you were doing this for the kids.
You really can't do this test at another time?
Next time you want a favour, don't bother asking.
You can tell him.
Greece the test Thursday.
Oh, what?
That's it.
Can you play anyway soon?
You know the rule. No train, no game.
So, well, simple, mate. You don't do the test. You're not going to let that fuck to run your life for you, eh?
Look, previous, if I don't do that test, my dad's going to kill me, all right?
You're not Tony Quinn, I say you.
Why don't you shut up, all right?
$5 for what?
Team shirts. You wear, you share.
Are you kidding? What type of shirt costs five?
Give me $5. $5, guys.
Come on, pay up. Come on! We need the money on the table. He's playing Simon this afternoon for shirts. Pay up.
Go on, play inside. Don't give him money versus any child. You gotta see.
Give him your money.
You're
full of it. I don't
want to know what it's for.
It's for dope, miss.
Well, talking about yourself, Rivers.
Oh, you are.
It's for charity, miss. It's off.
Oh, save it.
Hey, man, I'm a good boy. I'm a charity.
Come on, miss.
All right, can I have you sitting in your seats, please? And I want your assignments, and I want them now.
When you prefer dream vacation over a rental nightmare,
that's so tight.
It matters where you stay. Hilton for the stay.
You're never responsible for unauthorized purchases on your Discover card.
I put a spell on you.
Fragrance. Louis Vuitton.
What's with the fate?
How's it going, mate? My name's Con. This is my buddy Nick. We run the high school soccer team.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize. Wish some more respect.
Listen, mate, I got a proposition for you.
We need some shirts for our team, mate. Some proper soccer shirts.
How many?
15.
15 by $20, that's 300.
We haven't got that sort of money.
Goodbye.
Let me handle this. Listen, the point of this proposition is it doesn't cost you 20 to make them, right?
Try and understand something. Capitalism means you sell things for more than you pay for them, right? The difference is profit. School's out.
I'll play pool for it. $100 for 15 shirts.
You want to play me, Paul?
You scared to play me?
And I get to win $100.
Or you lose 15 shirts, it's up to you.
Let's play.
Put me off, man.
Yeah, tomorrow, right?
You're fine, put me off. I'm playing that shot again.
Come off it.
All right, the best out of three, then.
That wasn't the deal.
The fine put me off, man. That's not fair.
Life's not fair.
You cheated, didn't you? You got somebody to call you. Is that how you do business?
Now you're getting me angry.
Oh.
why?
It's an omen. We're not meant to have it anymore.
Come on, Nick.
Maybe he's right, maybe it's an omen.
Hey, don't you start with that stuff, okay, Chucker?
It wasn't me who said omen, you said it.
You only said it, you meant it.
Hey, losers! Can't you walks win anything? Hey, Rivers, don't just shut your mouth.
Oh, go play with your boyfriend, Stevie Weeby.
Hey. Don't worry about it. Forget it. Let's go. Come on.
Everybody's got something to do.
You want to double it? You dick. I said, do you want to double it?
Who am I playing?
Me. One game, sudden death, I break.
Your mate.
I saw you play before.
Play after work. You had a husband who drank like mine, did you? You'd have plenty of free time on your hands, too. Want to play again?
They put me off.
Huh? Pity, kid. It's not fair, eh, Simon?
That's not fair, really.
I've got things to do. Okay. Con, I don't want to see you playing for money in here again, okay?
Oh, come on, Ruby.
Okay. And as for you, I want 15 brand new soccer shirts, right?
Right, I'll mind that for
and
you.
And maybe you don't want to come in my place again.
All right, I'll do the shirts.
And don't take your time with them either, we need them fast.
Mate, I've got a lot of orders.
Oh, come on, don't make me say it twice.
All right, I'll do the shirts. But I need a design.
Give me a shirt, Nick. Come on, quick. Team colours, right? What are they? Red and black?
Yeah, I reckon simple stripes.
Okay,
nothing too complicated.
What we want is just plain red with thin black stripes about that far apart. Okay?
Yeah, it looks cool to me.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay.
Hang on a sec. And a black armband right here.
What for?
For Mrs. Poulos. She was the one who wanted uniforms for us. You know, our team leader is the manager, they wear a black armband. Mm. What I'm saying is that we wear it forever.
Me too.
Yeah.
Mm. Thanks, man.
Steve, what is it?
I don't know, I'm just...
What?
It's just that I see you guys looking out for each other, you know? I mean, you've got no soccer shirt, so you're bent rock on for the crazy scam he tried to pull on Simon, you know?
So?
So you look out for each other, right?
That's how it goes.
Yeah. Well, not in our league team, it doesn't. See, I'm Southgate's playmaker. Set up the goals, score the tries. But I don't think the man could really give a stuff whether I pass my HSC or not. Now, look, the bottom line is, Dan, I've got to fail my maths test to make him look good.
Hey, Southgate doesn't matter.
Yeah, but it's not just him, is it? Now, I'm supposed to have mates on that stinking team. I'm supposed to have friends. Peter Rivers is supposed to be a mate, right? Now I miss training one time. One time I miss it, and suddenly I'm a poofter. Yeah, well, you know, I've got a mind too, you know.
Well, why don't you use it? Come on, let's go.
Come on. Well, what do you reckon?
Hit it!
Mate, I reckon we're in trouble.
Do it again!
And again. Ta-da! What do you think? I mean, how did your dad like his shirts?
Sort of like that, but maybe no creases?
Creases. My best thing. You want to try while I check this to father?
Wow.
Oh, what? Oh, looking good, yes.
Mum used to test the meat with a skewer. A skewer is one of those things that looks like a long nail.
You think I don't know what a skewer looks like, huh? Sure I do.
In the second drawer. I thought everybody kept their skewers in the second drawer.
My stepmother used to keep them hanging up. I was never allowed to use them.
You had a stepmother?
Mm-hmm.
Was she evil?
I wouldn't say evil. Well, not very evil. A vampire, maybe. Or a werewolf. Not very good to be around that full moon.
You're joking, right?
Right. She wouldn't let me cook. Oh, great. This is gonna be great.
Mmm, hey, smells wonderful.
Yes, to father, my best thing.
Dad.
Yeah, ooh.
Dad, can Thea Stella stay for dinner?
Sure, that'd be nice if we can.
Oh, honey, I'm not really your auntie.
Just Stella then.
Hmm? Come on.
Tilt the watch to the light. Cut!
Hey, can I have the watch back?
Give me a minute alone with it. 60 seconds. Deal?
Not a deal. Ryan, can I have the watch back?
What watch?
Seriously?
Are we close?
Turn left in 4 miles.
No.
¿Cuáles son tus intenciones con mi nieto?
What are your intentions with my grandson?
Life's little problems fixed on Google Pixel, the only phone engineered by Google. Buy Google Pixel 7a and get Pixel Buds A series.
We got our shirts organized.
That's great.
Now all we need is a coach. Stew.
Stew. Come on, Stew. Stew's how you ruin meat. That's stifado. That's how Greeks improve it.
Listen, this team that we're playing next week, I've been watching them train.
How hungry is everyone?
I'm pretty hungry.
Not too much for me, thank you very much. Look, Nick, you know, don't waste your time spying on other teams. Practice.
Yeah, I know. Practice makes perfect.
No, it doesn't. Perfect practice makes perfect. You practice doing something the wrong way, you get very good at doing it the wrong way.
Yeah, you see, we need someone to tell us the difference.
Come on, thank you very much. Yes.
Anyway, about this team, their coach has taken the under 17 stateside.
High school teacher. What would he know?
At least they've got someone.
Is it okay?
Yeah.
You hate it, right?
No.
It's terrible, isn't it?
No.
It's terrible.
No.
Oh, why is he
great.
Doing that?
It's good. No, don't worry about him. He's always like that.
At least they've got someone.
I'm out here, the ladies are fighting again.
Wait a minute. Hey, I'm gonna recommend your work, you know that.
First time, these are all right.
Rubies?
Yeah. Well, all the big teams have sponsorship.
Yeah, they look great.
Good, aren't they? Terrific.
Wow. You know, they're better than our shirts.
It's a better game.
What are you staring at me for, Den?
Nothing.
I get it.
Get what?
You think I want to play for you guys, don't you?
Not a good idea.
And why is that?
Well, see, mate, it was like the last game we played. You'd go nuts. Insane. See, those guys were animals. Animales. Bestias.
Why would they do?
They wouldn't leave her alone. Couldn't even take their hands off her. Be careful.
Animals.
You're kidding me, right? Look, I'm not stupid here. I know exactly what you're trying to do.
If that's what you want to believe.
No.
Yeah, we're fine. Excellent. Hey, Ed. Yeah, a good footballer should look good. Shows a good attitude. Hey. What's this?
It's for Irini.
Oh, Irini?
Yeah. Oh. The whole team asked for it.
She was our manager, right? She was there for us, so we all agreed on it.
Better than yesterday.
Think so?
Yes, I do. I think stuffed cups against Estella's best.
I think they're stuffed.
What do you think, Dad?
I think I'm very proud of them. The kids in the team. Very proud.
Looks like we're just going to have to do it without you this time, Steve.
What can I say, Rivers? You're just going to have to get someone else to set up your tries for you, aren't you?
Look, miss, I understand that you feminine types don't know a lot about this stuff, but soccer team's got 11. You've only got 10 there. What's the GA?
None of your business.
Ooh. Rivers, man.
We're so good, we kick ass with 5. We don't need 11.
Oh, I'd like your door pull you, mate. So you're going to get old Ruby to jump in as well this time, right?
Nah, my lucky.
You got a pen, miss?
What are you doing, Stephen?
Just what it looks like, sir.
You joined soccer, you're out.
Oh, then. It looks like I'm out then, doesn't it?
Okay, stretching out to the side. Okay, everybody. And the other side. Stretch it out. Okay, now standing up, one leg in front of the other. Bending down, stretch it out.
Cut it out, miss. Too hard.
Okay, other leg.
The other leg. Here we go. Do some research, miss.
Yep. All right. Now, Joni on the spot.
Oh, here we go.
Come on, put some energy into it. Okay. Hitting your knees, please.
Oh, miss. Look, little visitor.
Oh, they're all yours.
So you think you're up against the top team?
Yeah, they're on top and we haven't won yet.
Right. Well, we're going to take them on. No, we're going to take on these rich kids with the fancy uniforms and the big playing fields, and we're going to beat them.
Yeah!
Okay.
And you think you're going to do that, Mr. Poulos?
We've got a couple of advantages, Steve. We are the underdogs, and we want it.
Yeah!
So what are we going to do about it?
Yeah.
We got some work to do, though. Come on! Close control over the ball. Stay up on your toes. Up on your toes. Good. Now listen to this while you're doing that. I'm not interested in champions, okay? You're a team. Work for each other. It's not just a pass, it's a pass to a person. Okay? A good pass that
results in a goal is as much your goal as it is the person who scored it. It's a team goal. We are a team. Work like a team.
Okay, so you've got to work to get yourself into the clear.
Dad?
It's got to do one of two things. It's going to draw the opposition to you so that somebody else can do something, or it leaves you clear to receive.
Dad?
It's called working for each other. Mm. Yes, honey?
Is it okay this afternoon if me and Stella put Mum's things into boxes?
You know, we don't touch anything for 40 days.
I check with Thea Helen. If things just have to stay in the house, there's nothing about not touching.
Auntie Helen, she makes things up as she goes along.
I think Mum thinks it's okay.
I think you're right, darling. Okay. Yeah, well, soccer.
Bundle Extrava Festa Save-a-thon. Give me an H.
H.
Give me an O.
O.
Give me a U.
Wait, it's an M next.
Oh.
This is why we need to practice more.
Tuesday nights are hard for me, Pam.
When you're a leader, the competition is always hoping that you're going to slip up. So, these suits are here to make sure that anything that I say is legally indisputable. Like, Apartments.com has the widest variety of variety. Apartments.com was the reason that apartments were invented. Heck, we got more spaces than space.
That's entirely incalculable.
Incalculable? Oh, I think that's legalese for true. Apartments.com, the place to find a place.
The greatest American rock and roll band in history, Aerosmith, present Peace Out. The Farewell Tour with special guest The Black Crowes. Get tickets now at LiveNation.com.
Good luck to them, mate. Good luck to them.
Hey, good luck.
Get down, mate.
And go!
Come on. Hey, come on.
All in. All in here. Okay, now, what do you reckon? Top team? Hey?
Yeah.
You're holding them. You're holding them. That's great. Okay, now what you could do is you move that ball down the right flank. Just keep it moving down the right flank, looking for the cross. Now, Steve and Nick, you drive down the centre, looking for the volley of the header, okay? Good, good. You're playing like a team. That's good. In my mind, you've already won. But do you want to beat them?
Yeah!
Okay, well, get out there and enjoy it! Yeah. Oh, come on.
Now, in real football, that would have been worth points.
Unless you've got something positive to say, don't say it.
Black armbands for, mate. Did one of your team overdose?
That's for our team manager, you jerk.
Hartley sucks, you bunch of losers.
Losers!
Hey, are you going to take them out or am I?
Losers!
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 I hate to tell you this, guys, but
Bum Jacker Cruz is going down!
Let Con take it, man. Look, I'll blow it.
You take it, all right? Show yourself, get out, son.
Come on, Steve. Thank you.
bad girl.